Well, as we reported earlier this morning, a third major poll in as many days has confirmed Labor's dumping of Kevin Rudd has paid immediate dividends for the federal government. TEN's political editor Paul Bongiorno joins us now with all the details from Canberra. Paul, good morning. So could these latest polls be making some Labor MPs feel a little bit better that what they did by putting Julia Gillard in as PM was the right thing?
Well, good morning, Natasha. Look, there's no doubt that a significant minority of the Labor caucus felt that they could still win with Kevin Rudd. Even though he had fallen from the stratosphere of Kevin 07, he was now a mere mortal. It'd be a white-knuckle ride. But I've got to say, a significant and an overwhelming, rather, majority of the Labor caucus were relieved that Julia Gillard put up her hand. They believe that she's a surer bet and that she could more credibly reposition the government. This is what Jenny Macklin had to say about that on Meet the Press.
There was a strong mood for change, a strong desire to see Julia Gillard become the Prime Minister. Nevertheless, we do have to acknowledge the significance of such a change. I think she will bring a really different approach, different priorities, and already you can see the Australian people responding.
So, Paul, will Labor capitalise on these good polls straight away by calling an immediate election? There's even speculation it could be as early as August.
Well, that's right. Well, if it is August, it won't be called straight away. In fact, the Greens leader, Bob Brown, is tipping August 28. If it is August 28, then Julia Gillard could announce it at the end of the school holidays in New South Wales and the ACT on the weekend of about the 18th of July. That'd give the statutory length of time to the 28th of August election. Now, there is a lot of feeling within the Labor government that Julia Gillard should capitalise on the honeymoon period. But one of Labor's canniest strategists, Bruce Hawker, who'll be working on the campaign, sounds this note of warning.
She now has to set her own tone, I think, and her own agenda in the government, and that'll take a little bit of time. So I think it would be they'd want to be careful about rushing too quickly to get the judgment of the electorate right now.
Now, Julia Gillard this morning is going to Queanbeyan, which is in Eden Monaro, which is the bellwether marginal seat. And then this afternoon, early afternoon, she'll probably announce her cabinet reshuffle. The word is that it'll be quite minimal and that Kevin Rudd won't be in it.
Thank you for the update. Paul Bongiorno joining us there with the details from Canberra.